With the weather all gray and rainy, it's time for something warm and satisfying, like a big pot of hot tea and carts of steaming dim sum. Today, we're going to visit four of the best dim sum places in San Francisco. Dim sum is probably the most popular form of Chinese cuisine here in the Bay Area. Dim sum in Cantonese, or dianxing in Mandarin, translates to touch the heart. Dim sum can be traced back 2,500 years ago when it was originally created as small bites, or tapas, that the royal courts and the upper class could enjoy with their tea in a leisurely fashion. In fact, some restaurants call it yam cha or yin cha for drink tea, which is why the portions are itty-bitty bite-size. So a modern dim sum experience usually involves a huge sit-down dining hall with little old ladies wheeling around, carts piled high with food, and huge pots of steaming tea in the middle of the table. But today's four restaurants are completely different takes on the dim sum experience. So let's go check it out. San Francisco's Chinatown is the oldest and the largest in the U.S., and some of the shops have been around here for about 100 years. One of the best out there is Good Mong Kok Bakery on Stockton Street, and it's an old, old fixture of the hood. It opens at 7 a.m., so on the weekends, go early before the line forms up. There isn't a menu, and the ladies behind the counter don't speak English, so if your Chinese is rusty or non-existent, you're just going to have to point a lot and hold up a couple of digits to indicate how many you want. Also, the counter ladies move the queue fast, so scope out what you want beforehand. Otherwise, if you wait too long at the front of the line, you're gonna draw the ire of the employees as well as all the other patrons behind you in line waiting for you to go. And as with most of these counter places, cash only. Okay, so given that this place is counter service only, everything is strictly to go. Want to grab your stuff? I'll show you a couple places where you can go park yourself and consume your goodies. About a 5-minute walk down is the Transamerica building, and it has a popos, or a privately owned public open space. If you don't know what these are, I will provide a link to it at the end of this video. In short, it's an oasis in the city, and we'll find a nice little park and great benches to sit. Right next to the Transamerica building is the Redwood Park. You could grab a seat at any of these benches behind me and have a little picnic. And if it's too cold or raining, you can easily pop into 505 Sansom next door, which has a popos in the lobby area. Perfect, some chairs back here. Good Mong Kok is best known for its sasubao or steamed pork buns, but you can also get variants with chicken or vegetables in it. This time I have gotten the chicken filling. The outside is a steamed sweet bread, which is light and fluffy. And the filling is like a giant meatball with chicken, vegetables like cilantro, and some seasoning. A superior meat filling will be very juicy inside. Best to eat this while it's hot. Yummy. Very, very soft. And the meatball kind of falls apart when you chew on it. So I got some Shiu Mai and a Har Gow dumpling. Traditionally, the filling is ground pork and shrimp, and then wrapped around the outside is a wonton wrapper, which is made with flour and egg. The dumplings at Good Mong Kok aren't necessarily the most refined, but they are huge and such a good value. All of this together was about $4. Okay, let's try this out. Steamed to perfection. Look how juicy and pink that meat is inside. And the balance of the pork blend is really nice. You get some fatty pieces in there, which tastes super rich on your tongue. The meat inside is really super soft, and so it really just falls apart and dissolves in your mouth when you eat it. My only complaint is the wrapper, which can get a little bit soggy. Okay, that whet my appetite. Let's go on to the next one. All the locals know that the new Chinatown is located to the west in the Sunset and Richmond neighborhoods. This is where the newer immigrants settle, bringing with them more contemporary cuisines fresh from Asia and targeted at a younger crowd, like squid ink dumpling, which we're gonna try today. One of the biggest dim sum empires in the whole Bay Area is Koi Palace, with its huge banquet halls in Daly City, Milpitas, Dublin, and now this new location back behind me here in Richmond, which was just opened in 2015. Even though this mini koi palace outpost is called Dragon Boat, reflect its more contemporary outlook, it still features some of the best-selling items off the koi menu. I've gotten here a little bit earlier than its 11 o'clock opening time just to get in line so we can get a table. To the Western eye, the decor may be a bit on the garish side, but this is modern by Asian standards.
In the afternoon, they serve dim sum, and in the evenings, they switch to hot pot. Because this is the city, the space is small for Koi Palace standards, and the tables are kind of jammed in together here, so there's not really a whole lot of space for carts to maneuver. Instead, you fill out one of these order forms here and hand it in to the waiter. Good thing there's lots of nice big pictures on it. The most popular signature dish here is called the Five Guys or Wu Cai Xiaolongbao, also known as soup dumplings. This is a sampler plate of five different kinds of dumplings. You've got your traditional pork filling here, a spinach wrapper with a kale filling. This one here is a beet wrapper with a fresh beet filling. This one's got a turmeric wrapper with crab roe on the inside. And this one last here is the squid ink filling with a black truffle filling. They already come in their own little spoon for you. So to eat, simply break the wrapper, release all the soup, drain into the spoon so that it cools down a little. You can add a little bit of the vinegar and eat. That soup has a really delicious broth. The skin is nice and thin, although I would say in general the proportion of wrapper to filling is much larger than normally what I'm used to with xiaolongbao. Okay, let's try this black truffle one. Tasty, just a small hint of the black truffle in there. Crab roe. That's a much richer filling in there, and that crab roe gives it that very distinct ocean flavor to it. This beet one should be interesting. Very earthy, and there's a little bit of steamed carrot underneath all of these dumplings, and with the beet one, it adds just a slight bit of sweetness to it. And last but not least, the spinach and kale. There's a slightest bit of kale in that, just enough to give it a little bit of that green springtime flavor to it. Overall, interesting and fun to order just to get a taste of some very different flavors you're never going to get in xiaolongbao. But at the end of the day, stick to the tried and true traditional pork one. Okay, we're not going to fill up too much because we have more restaurants to go.
You wouldn't think it, but one of the most delicious dim sum joints in the city is located in the Castro. On residential 18th Street is Mama G's, a homey little mom and pop shop. Back in 2012, this was the Queen Malik Crepe Cafe with Mama G doing a weekend pop-up dim sum. The handmade dumplings were being prepared by Yangtze alum chef Li Guozhong. And about a year later, Mama G took over the whole entire shop and set up permanently. And in addition to the delicious dim sum, she also makes spectacular Sichuan from her hometown in China. Again, space is too small for carts, so you will need to order off the menu and have the waitstaff bring your food to you. You pair your dim sum with a glass of wine or craft beer from their very respectable collection. I got a barrel-aged fruit lambic sour on tap. Cheers! I got some of the fan favorites, which are a little bit more unique and not as readily available elsewhere. These are cilantro shrimp dumplings or xiangqingjiao.
The outside of this wrapper is a wheat and potato starch flour, which is why it's translucent.
And then the inside is a plump, juicy shrimp. Sometimes the cilantro is bound to it with a little bit of ground pork. Then they're steamed to juicy perfection.
Here in California, cilantro is more readily identified with Mexican cuisine, but in fact, it's been used in Chinese cuisine for thousands of years. Cilantro is well known for its pungency, and the literal translation from Chinese is sweet-smelling vegetable. It's also believed to have medicinal and aphrodisiac qualities. Okay, enough talking. Time for eating. Okay, that's perfectly cooked. The wrapper is tender, yet not soggy, and the cilantro gives it that kick and pungency.
So good.
And if you're kosher, no pork bindings in this one. And the shrimp are just this side of done, still really plump and firm. And I also got the pea sprout shrimp dumplings, or dou miao jiao. Pea sprouts are a very popular Chinese vegetable. Usually it's prepared, picked fresh, and just simply stir-fried with some garlic. It's got dark green leaves, and it has this delicious, crunchy sweet taste to it. These pea sprout dumplings are prepared in a very similar fashion, except instead of cilantro, they've got pea sprouts in them. Time to give it a try. There's ginger thrown in there as well, and it's got this fantastic green, springtime, fresh flavor to it. These are so airy and light, I could easily eat two or three more orders. But I'm not. I'm gonna take them to go, because I got one more place to hit after this. We are gonna round off our list with perhaps the most popular dim sum spot in San Francisco, Yangtze in the Financial District. It's the gold standard. There are two locations. This location here in the Rincon Center is the original location, and there's a second location just down the street on Stevenson. The food is extremely high quality, the ambiance is elegant, and the service impeccable. And this has earned it a spot on the Michelin Guide. And the prices reflect this. For the cost of one order of pork barbecue buns, you could buy five at Good Mong Kok. However, this is everything that you would imagine a classical dim sum experience to be. Yangtze was originally opened in Chinatown in 1958 and was moved upscale to the Rincon Center in 2001, where there was plenty more room to maneuver. The restaurant seats a good 250 people with big wide aisles for carts. Here is a must. The leaves are super fragrant and they serve them in their signature glass modern pot. Try either their pu'er or their white chrysanthemum tea or juhua for non-caffeinated. For food here, stick to the classics and you will not go wrong. Quality and price-wise.
A popular dish is the individual portions of Peking duck. Each comes with thin slices of raw cucumber, scallion, a piece of juicy duck with crispy honey glazed skin, a plump taco-shaped bun, and a side of hoisin or plum sauce. Self-assembly is required. Place the items in the bun to your liking, and when fully assembled, pop it in your mouth.
That is super yummy. The duck skin is very crispy, and I love that they deboned the meat already for you. The bread is plump and yeasty, and I love that contrast of the mellowness against the tanginess of the duck and the hoisin sauce. And even though the meat is lean, it's still quite tender and juicy. Don't miss this. It sometimes comes around in the carts, but more than likely, you're gonna have to order it. And we have to end our meal endless with a traditional dessert.
While many restaurants feature the ever-popular sesame balls with their chewy rice flour mochi shell fried to a crispy perfection on the outside and rolled in sesame seeds, Yangtze's puppies are delicately stuffed with an unusual filling, yam and lotus seed paste. The yam and lotus seed are mixed with sweeteners and a bit of oil for a rich, creamy texture.
That's the perfect sweet bite. The outside is crispy with the nuttiness of the sesame. Then inside, you've got this chewy, mochi texture. And at the center is the sweet burst of the yam and the lotus paste. It's rich without being too sweet. Kind of like a Chinese donut.
Oh my God, I am so stuffed. I am going to end this video with one last dim sum word of wisdom. While the common urge is to shovel the yummy food down your gullet as fast as humanly possible, remember that dim sum was created to be a leisurely affair, enjoyed over good conversation and lots of cups of tea. So take your time and enjoy. Happy yum sum. Until the next time, peace out.